While Lightroom is filled with powerful editing tools that you can use to improve and enhance your photos, I'm going on record as saying that there is nothing more powerful than the masking panel. And it's not only because of the robust selection tools that you have at your disposal, each of which provides creative ways to make seriously refined selections. On top of these powerful selection tools, what makes Lightroom's masking panel so robust is the fact that you can expand that functionality by allowing multiple masks to interact with each other. And that's where the real creative potential of masking shows itself. So for this video, I'm going to show you three primary ways that masks can interact with each other. They are add, subtract, and intersect. My hope is that this will encourage those of you who have been avoiding the masking panel to give it a shot. And everything I show you in this video works exactly the same in Lightroom and Lightroom Classic. So let's dive in. Now for this video, I'm not going to go over how each of these masks works, but let me know in the comments if that's a video that you'd like to see. And of course, make sure you click on subscribe so that you don't miss out when it goes live. For this video, I want to focus on how masks can interact with each other. Now you might know that a mask can be applied individually. So I can go ahead, for example, and select the brush and then paint in, and anywhere that I have this selection, that's where any edits that I make will appear. But that's just one selection. I just used the brush and I made a stroke. The power, like I mentioned, of masking is that you can combine multiple masks together to make really refined adjustments. So let's start with the most basic one, which is add. I'm gonna go ahead here and delete this brush mask just because I don't want it right now. Let's say I wanna darken the left and the right side of this image evenly. Well, what I could do is I could take a linear gradient and I can draw this way, and then I could drop my exposure, and then I could say, all right, well, now I'll create another linear gradient and I'm gonna draw it from the right side. And then I'll have to go back and say, okay, well, I used a negative 0.96, so I'll go back here and, you know, I can type in over here, negative 0.96, and okay, you know, now they're matching. But I have these two different masks and it's kind of cumbersome because it's like, oh, all right, actually this is too dark, so I'm actually gonna increase the exposure. And then I have to go back to this one and increase the exposure by the same amount. And it's just, like I said, cumbersome. So that's where the add modifier comes in. I'm gonna go ahead and delete all of the masks again. And just like before, I'm gonna select linear gradient and I'm gonna make my left selection. And the power of add is that it allows me to combine this linear gradient with any other masking tool in one selection. So if I click on add, the first thing you'll see is the entire masking list. So you can combine, like I said, linear gradient with anything else. And so for the example that I just showed you, I'm gonna select linear gradient again, and this time I'm gonna drag from the right. And so now you can see we have this one mask, but we have two different selection tools under it. And this is very powerful. You can do things like rename the top level mask. So I can call this edge darken. I can then go to this first linear gradient and rename this one to left edge. And then I can repeat the process and call this right edge. But because both of these selections were added together, I added the left to the right, I can go to the mask here, and when I adjust any of the settings, you can see how it's applying the edit to both of the selections evenly. So I don't have to go back and forth and switch and make sure that I have the same values. All right, now I wanna show you how subtract works. To start, I'm gonna go ahead and delete this entire mask. And let's say I wanna create a custom vignette. I could go to the global edit tools, scroll down, and under effects, you'll see there is vignette. The thing about this vignette is that it basically darkens the edges evenly from all four corners, which might work for you, but you don't really have many refined controls other than, for example, the midpoint, the shape, and the feather, as well as whether you want to preserve highlights. So let's say you want to customize your vignette. Well, I'm going to go to masking here and I'll show you how to do that. Let's start by selecting a radial gradient and making kind of an oval shape. This will ultimately be kind of the shape and position of your vignette. So if I want to, you know, make it really narrow as far as oval shape goes, I can. And I can also position it. Let's say I want it to be more up here. I can do that. Whereas with the global vignette, the midpoint always goes to the center of the image. Now here's the thing, this has nothing to do with subtract, but with a custom vignette, you see I made this radial gradient. If I start dropping the exposure, it is actually applying the edit to the selection. By default, the selection for a radial gradient is the inside confine of that, and I want the opposite. So if I undo this, what you'll want to do is click on this invert button, and now if I drop the exposure, you can see how the selection here does not have that edit applied, rather everything outside of it does. Now let's go ahead. I'm a big fan of naming masks, so I'm going to call this custom vignette, just so I know that is what this mask does. And so here's the problem. You can see how the vignette is doing exactly what we want it to do, but it's spilling on top of the bird, which I don't want. I kind of want this vignette to cut behind it. I want to kind of sculpt around the bird. So how can we do that? Well, we can subtract. So similar to add, when I click on subtract, we have the same mask menu. And honestly, this is where the fun of masking comes in, because it allows you to use your creativity. It allows you to use all of the masking tools to figure out creative ways to combine or to exclude masks from each other. So when I look at this, I'm like, all right, I see that I have this radial gradient and it's darkening everything outside of the shape. I also know that I want to preserve the bird. So thinking about subtract, which one of these masking tools would give me the desired result? Well, I think the adaptive subject mask could work. So I'm going to click on this. And because Lightroom has such intelligent subject selections, you can see how the mask now doesn't include the bird. And so if I toggle this, you can see how the bird is not being darkened. Now, let's say you're not a fan of the subject selection. Let's go ahead and delete subject one. We can try something else. Let's go subtract, and maybe this time let's select objects. I'm going to use the marquee tool here, and I'm just going to make a selection around the bird. And this also did a good job, but it kind of added this weird selection down here by the claw. You can see, watch, if I toggle this, I kind of don't want this part of the tree in there. So what does that mean? Well, we can continue using add and subtract. So I used subtract with the object masking tool to subtract the bird. But now what I want to do is add back this little section of the tree. So I'll go ahead here, I'll select add, and I think the brush is the best tool for this job. Let's go ahead and reduce the brush size. I'm going to make sure that flow is set to maybe like, I don't know, 70%, and density is at 100. And now what I can do is just slowly paint in this area here. And I'm just restoring that part of the mask. So right around here looks good. And I'm not going to spend too much time, but the point is you can see how I can use both subtract and add in the same mask to get an even more refined selection. All right, there is one more way that masks can interact with each other. We looked at add and subtract and how you can use add and subtract in the same mask. You don't have to do one or the other. The third one is intersect. I save this for the end because, one, I think it trips up people more than add or subtract, but two, it is the most powerful of the three, in my opinion. So let me show you how that works. Let's go ahead here. I'm going to delete the masks again. Now, let's say I want to just edit the yellow in the bird. So I could go to range, for example, and select color range and click here. And here you can see with the overlay the problem. Do you see how the color is being selected throughout the entire image, not only within the bird, but also in the background? So if I were to go ahead here and drop exposure or increase exposure, you see how it's applying to the entire image, not just to the bird. That's where intersect comes in. So let's go ahead. I'm going to delete this mask. And so to explain what intersect is, all of the tools that I just showed you, whether it's the brush or the gradients or the color range tool, those are selection tools. Those are tools that you have at your disposal to make a creative selection within your image based on certain criteria, whether it's a brush, which is just select anything that I draw on, or a color range, which is select anything within this color range. So what Intersect does is it allows you to make a selection within a selection. Let me show you what I mean by that. All right, so if I were to ask you, what selection would you make, and then what selection within that selection would you make, that would define your Intersect. So the criteria I said is, I want to select the yellow within the bird. So the first thing I would need to do is define my total selection. And so that would be the bird. So I can go ahead here and select subject. We know that it does a good job of selecting the bird. And there you can see, we now have the bird selected. So as far as Lightroom is concerned, its entire universe right now is this bird selection. It doesn't care about anything outside of this overlay. So that's our primary selection. And now that we have that defined, remember, I said I want to edit only the yellow range within this bird. And so that means we need to use Intersect. So to Intersect, what you'll do is you'll click on this little tri-dot icon on the mask level, and you'll see this option here called Intersect with Mask Using. I know it's kind of a mouthful. There's also a hidden way to access Intersect from the masking panel here. If you press and hold on the Option key on Mac or the Alt key on Windows, you see how the Add and Subtract turn into Intersect. So it's just kind of like a hidden shortcut. And so if I click on that, we get the same mask menu. And so again, you have to ask yourself, I have my bird as the primary selection. So what other masking tool can I use to achieve the selection result that I'm going for? I said that I want to select yellow, and so it makes sense to use color range. So I'm gonna click on this, and then I'm just gonna click over here. And now, remember before when I used color range, we had the selection within the bird, and then we also had the selection within the background, which we didn't want. Now we only have the selection within the bird. I can go ahead and use this refine slider to restrict or to add more of that color value. So here I'll go right around, I don't know, maybe right around here is fine. But you can see we still have some of that area here selected, some over here, some down here. So what can we do about that from what we've learned? Well, if we want to remove something from a selection, we can use subtract. So let's go ahead and select subtract. And again, in this case, I think the brush would work well. And so I'm just gonna increase the brush size a little bit. I'm also gonna make the flow 100. And I'm just going to remove these areas here that I know I don't want. Just go down here. And I'm not gonna spend a lot of time, but just to show you how the brush can work here. So you can use intersect with add and subtract as well. It's not one or the other. And now what I can do is select the mask. I can go ahead and increase the exposure a bit. And you see how it's only affecting the selection within the beak and around the eye. I can increase saturation, maybe increase highlights, and even add a bit of texture. And it's only applying to the selection here, which is so powerful. It's only applying to wherever this overlay shows up. And you can see if I toggle this, you can see it's only applying there, which is, again, just so awesome. All right, so I know it's not a lot, right? It's add, subtract, and intersect, but it's also a lot because it requires you to first understand each of the different selection tools in the masking panel. There are several of them. They're very powerful. But when you add the extra dimension of combining or excluding or intersecting them together, I understand that it can get a bit confusing. So I really hope this video helps. Do me a favor also and let me know in the comments, did this help you? Because I wanna make sure, like I said, masking is the most powerful part of Lightroom in my opinion. And I wanna make sure that this makes all of you who might have been intimidated or not even explored this tool feel more comfortable. Now, masking is just a small part of Lightroom. There's so much more to Lightroom for desktop and mobile and web. And if you want to learn everything there is to know, then check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Now, I mentioned how Intersect is very powerful, and you could do it on Lightroom Mobile, but there's no specific Intersect tool. I've got this video to show you how that works. Of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated, as is clicking on subscribe and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.